Okay. So, thanks for coming. So, for your interest in Kibana, maybe later we can share about what's your particular interest in Kibana. So, let's see. So, Kibana is a browser based. As of version 3, it's a pure HTML, CSS implementation of an analytics and search tool, right? Which is a graphical interface for Elasticsearch, right? Familiar with Elasticsearch? Or
a little bit, maybe.
A basic level.
Okay, okay. But Elasticsearch is a data store. It's a document store that supports indexing, right? And search, right? And the works. So it's like, well, it's not a traditional database, but it stores your documents. And so Kibana actually talks to Elasticsearch, like giving, issuing queries and showing you the results.
It's on top of, I'm not reaching into the data store.
Sorry?
It's on top of the APIs.
It's using the APIs, yes. So you use Kibana to visualize logs and timestamp data, right? The most common example they use is Apache logs. Okay, how many PHP? How many requests for PHP documents do you have? For PNG, what countries they're from, right? What are the sizes of the documents you're sending out, right? And things like that. So.
This means that my basic intro to Elasticsearch was more of search and documents, right? So when you say logs, so you mean you throw log data into Elasticsearch?
Yes, correct. So, yeah. So Kibana reads from Elasticsearch. It doesn't actually put real so-called data inside.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, as we see later, it actually does, but more for its own configuration.
So logging into the Elasticsearch yourself.
Yes. So that's where we are coming to. Where they fit in. Elasticsearch is actually a big umbrella. It's quite confusing at first when I first see it, because Elasticsearch is also the name of the search, the data store called Elasticsearch, and it is also the organization that comprises Logstash, Elasticsearch, and so you get kind of lost when you're trying to understand it for at the start.
Are you using Elasticsearch right now?
Yes.
What are you using it for?
We are using it. I'm actually getting to there in the latest slide. Oh, So, you might have some common questions like, okay, what do they do? What do they actually do? Logstash, Elasticsearch, Kibana. So, where they fit in? You hear you see presentations and websites talking about Logstash, Elasticsearch, and Kibana all at once, right? So Logstash is for collection, aggregation, and parsing, right? And for transforming, filtering input raw logs into structured data, structured documents. And one of the outputs is, of course, Elasticsearch. So if you just download the entire Logstash bundle, it includes Elasticsearch and Kibana. But of course, you can download them separately as well. So, well, of course, as we mentioned, Elasticsearch is the storage and indexing and search, right? Where that's the whole data store, right? All the clustering, replication, blah blah blah, it happens in Elasticsearch. And Kibana will be the UI, right? It shows you the graphs, the visualizations, the dashboards. Right? So that's how I see it. So what are we using it for? in our case, my team is responsible for maintaining a mid-tier service for wallet instrument information, maybe like say your credit cards, right? Your bank accounts and preferences, which one do you want to use at where, so stuff like those. A lot of reading, right? Queries, reading, and then we keep getting requests to can you lower your latency? Can you lower your latency? Right. So you have to see what they are, right? And which are the where are the bottlenecks? What are the ones that are worth working on, right? So sometimes the ops will tell you, oh, you have some timeouts, you have spikes and whatever, right? So you basically, by looking at raw logs, you're not going to achieve much, right? So right, we all identify with that, right? So identify spikes or fluctuations. You can see, well, with this I actually saw that, okay, within that reported time period, we had a request that actually was lasting for 90 seconds, even though the client was long timed out after 10. And then you can say, let's have this. Companies nowadays are all obsessed with SLAs, right? Latency. So okay, where do we start? Okay, so we know that our 95th percentile is 2 seconds. So let's just say 2.5, right? For example. And prioritize optimization work when we are in charge of returning or querying a lot of different sources of data. Some might be faster, some might be slower, right? So we don't want to we want to say work on the ones that are taking the longest. And with Kibana, you see the graphs. Okay, this line is like actually much higher than the querying this other type of instrument. So it helps you to prioritize. So why Kibana? Why did we actually explore this solution? Right, it is mainly the tight integration between essentially Elasticsearch and Kibana. So side benefit that you have is it's scalable. So if you run out of space, you need more nodes. Theoretically, you can add more Elasticsearch nodes, and the replication and the clustering will be done for you. But that will be the topic of another talk. It's also flexible in the sense that the Kibana allows the users to create their own dashboards, so that the developers don't have to do it. Oh, I want this other metric, and I want this color to be green. Right. So the traditional way, right? Well, we have several other teams that are already doing log visualization and monitoring, but they're doing it quote traditional way. You define a database schema. You want to see this request latency. You want to see a response latency. So you have a column for each of those, right? You define this, and imagine the maintenance of this schema, right? I'm not even going to start. Right. So database maintenance is a chore, and there's usually some kind of intermediate processing. Okay. So you want to derive some median or quantile for this particular type of information. You say, how many people have more than 10 credit cards? Okay, then you kind of have to put in some configurations, right? Okay, I want this kind of rule, 10 cards. Okay, then you have to run those things, and create intermediate data, right? That's, and of course, I want this line to be green, right? Right, one phrase, too much work, right? So leave it to the users, right? And so with this solution, all we actually need to do, what I actually found myself doing more is the initial passing of the raw logs into structured documents and sending them into Elasticsearch. And that's actually about it, right? Create a few sample dashboards and tell, right, tell the people who have been asking me for information, okay, right, figure it out, and they're very happy to do that, right? So of course, the basic feature of Kibana is search. You can query by plain text in general. What you're seeing here is like HTML, CSS, GIF, PHP, right? And because every document inside Elasticsearch is a structured JSON object, the structure is arbitrary, but within they kind of have to be consistent, right? Within the same index, you shouldn't really have wildly different, like if you have a field called A and it's a integer, the other document should also be an integer, otherwise yep.
So it's not a good idea to mix pets and aircraft parts in the same index.
Right. Yes. Yes.
Because the query results will probably be kind of meaningless.
Yeah, you can't aggregate those things right on the same field. Right. That's basically a practical limitation. So your queries, you can do a general query, or you can also query by field. Right. You say, my pet name is Lucas Jack. Right. And you can be as specific or if you know the search feature is backed by Apache Lucene, right? You can use the same syntax to query for those. And of course, filters. You have a time filter, and also you get a query filter, right? So you use a combination of queries and filters to narrow down the scope of your results. Okay. And they actually overlap. You can do it either way, right? But the recommendation is that query first, and then you and do your filter. So and you also have after your queries and filters are done, you can have a table which shows you the fields, the and the values, right? And if you take a look here, you can actually see like you can view it in JSON format. The raw is actually the same, just that JSON has a syntax highlighting, right? And then you can for the graphs, you can look at the number, the count, right? The number of documents that match this query, or if you're looking at values like response times or whatever, okay, what's the minimum, what's the average, maximum, and total. This is for a histogram, right? That's where it's applicable. And some more features is there's also you can also have a field filter that you can click on these, and I'm gonna do a demo in a little bit, right, to actually see this in action. So you can see, okay, if you click on they're obviously from different different indexes. So click on country and you see, okay, CN came up 34 times. These are the top ranking occurrences, right? And you can again show these up as pie charts, bar graphs, among a few. Right. So what I find cool about Kibana is that whatever users like to see, they can pretty much do self-service, right? And if you set up some you can share dashboards, you can save them. It uses Elasticsearch to save your configurations, right? And it loads from them. So wherever you are, you go to a new browser, new computer, right? No matter, right? Just start up Kibana, it's there, right? Start up Elasticsearch is there. You can import, export dashboards to file and also to GitHub.
So specific.
Specific as in GitHub. Oh, well, it's. I guess they can add more, but I think since GitHub is more popular, right? And good thing is for us the developers, we can get our hands dirty and kind of do what we want. We can even add something in Kibana to say populate some data, even though it's actually just reading, because it's just querying. Or the API is all doable from using jQuery.
This and the use case are quite internal stakeholder kind of dashboard. Does Kibana provide for external?
Like authorization?
Yes.
Yes.
Partial data set.
I have not explored those yet. So my use case was purely internal for now. But I do know there's some authorization that you can plug in. So, but out of the box is just open.
Open.
Yeah. I think the authorization you can actually do with your web browser. Not your web browser. Sorry, your web server.
HTTP.
Yeah.
That's
a good question. Yeah.
Are they so pretty then? It feels. Do it for them,
multi-tenant
purpose. I would like to use this.
Interesting. If you have all the data in the index, right? You're saying like some subset of data that they can't touch.
Yeah, like you run a service for 5 businesses, and you would like all this for them.
Mm.
Then since you can't filter out the 4 businesses for one. Mm-hmm. Then you have to redo the pie chart.
Yeah.
The other case would be like you have 5 or 6 searches and 5 people.
Yeah, probably. It's
probably
a
better.
Design issue.
Because you have separate businesses, right? Yeah, these are shouldn't be issue. And the purpose of Elasticsearch is solely as fast.
I think it that will turn out to be more of a system architecture problem, how you organize your design.
Because as much as you want to provide the 5,
yeah,
as the overall all running business, you also want to know the overall. Then like maybe I have 6 Elasticsearch. Yeah, so filter for Kibana.
I think if you segregate by indexes, it would be fine. But that again is your web server, because the way you query your index is in the is part of the URL, right? Then you can set up your web server to do different kinds of. As long as you're authorized to access that URL path, right? You will be able to. Whatever is inside that index. But yeah, if you're mixing different customer data within the same index, then I guess that's another that's another problem to solve. So besides that, it scales with Elasticsearch. Elasticsearch itself, if it's in a cluster, you can tell, right? You just ask any node and you can get information on the entire cluster. So you can spread out the load. Well, basically with it's a zero configuration kind of thing. It scales with you. Right. Okay, we're getting into some pictures here. The main thing is for Kibana, I think is the histogram, right? These are time interval buckets. Say this per 10 minutes, you can configure it to like per 1 second, 1 minute, whichever, or 1 year. So that's where all the count, the minimum, maximum, average, and the totals come in, all with respect to a single bucket. And remember we talked about not having to do intermediate data processing, because then you have the flexibility to change your bucket size, right, in real time, right? And of course the trade-off is that in real time you have to do some more processing. Okay. What you're seeing now is a cumulative stack of these colors correspond to different queries, like this, like HTML, PNG, right, JPEG. And you also have it also has a map, right, for especially good for web servers, Apache logs, country codes, right? You have 5,000 guys in requests from Brazil. So I deliberately generated the data from only a few countries, right, to make it a bit more obvious. Right, so the darker the color, the higher the count. So we can actually try it out live here. There's a demo.kibana.org, but unfortunately it has been flaky since last night. It was still working last night. This is their site, not mine. So okay. And the dashboards. So they have some sample stuff like they have a Gundev's map. they're actually updated like on a daily basis. Yeah. So yeah, even this is not working. So okay. And of course I have mine here. I changed the theme. Okay, so if you want to want to roll up your sleeves, get your hands dirty, what you need is Elasticsearch, which is basically a Java application. And just for Kibana, it's just a set of web pages and JavaScript files. So the best way to get the latest and greatest is clone the repo, plus any web server at all, right? Node.js, Nginx, or even the...
Like you said, it's pure client-side.
Yeah, it's pure client-side. The earlier version, version 2, before version 3, version 2 used to be a Ruby app, but I think he decided to change that, right, to make it...
Question, where's the stash rate? You have to download it separately.
Sorry?
Logstash, is it part of the...
Oh, Logstash it's all like Elasticsearch.
Okay.
Download. So, this part. It's the same place. Logstash. Yeah, see, that's the confusing part about this.
Sorry.
This website. So, you can see that Elasticsearch.org, Elasticsearch, Kibana, Logstash, and Hadoop. But Hadoop is actually the Hadoop connector for Elasticsearch. So now you can see why I'm confused.
I'm confused.
Yeah. Right. So, yeah. So I didn't go much into the you know, features, but because it's all here.
Yeah, I see the multi-tenancy part as part of Elasticsearch.
Yeah.
Okay, so I put one Kibana in front of each.
I see. Okay. So, yep. Schema-free, right? RESTful API, operation persistence. Okay.
Sweet.
Yeah. So, I started off looking, playing with Logstash and trying out the filters and whatnot. But in the end, I discovered I don't really need Logstash because for me, my raw logs are coming from another web server. And Logstash, unfortunately, does not have an input adapter for querying from a web service, right, from a URL. So no point looking for files and whatever. Syslog, right, TCP, UDP.
Logstash.
Yeah, Logstash, right? That's your aggregator. So if you if you're actually looking at like some collecting, you have a cluster of machines, you have where they have rolling log files, right? Yes, then you can have a Logstash instance running on each of them. Looking at those files, and depending on how you configure, you can transform them into structured data. Yeah, and sending them to Elasticsearch, all without writing any code. But of course, no code means configuration, and a lot of regular expressions, blah blah blah. Well, not that in code that you don't need, but
you can't use Logstash because your logs are.
I still had to write my own. I found that I still had to write my own script to like pull them down, right? And after I put them down, I was sending them to Logstash, which was sending it to Elasticsearch. Then why do I need the middleman? I cut the middleman there. But that's purely my own circumstance. Yeah. So so strictly speaking, Logstash is not really necessary, which is why I kind of said bare minimum you need Elasticsearch and Kibana, right? So, okay. This will be our hands-on demo. Are we able to see this? Okay. You can see the here there are some of the queries. Star means it matches everything. For example, I'm doing some country, right? Country is my field name, colon US GB AU, and the colored lines correspond to how many hits we have. I'm not doing any filtering right now, but you can. Yeah. And you can actually inspect the query. It shows you what it's looking for, and if you actually copy this outright and run it at the command line, it works. So this is the example of histogram. And that's where you have your count, min, mean, max, total. I was working on this, so I was adding this 95th percentile thing. So, and you can specify the field that you want, right? So it does an autocomplete for you. Scale your timestamp. Okay, the thing about Kibana is heavily timestamp based. So if you say I want to plot like can I plot like a arbitrary y versus x? You know, where x is not a timestamp. No. Right. But of course, there's nothing to stop you from doing that. But right now, Kibana does not support that.
So you're saying the x-axis is always a time, right?
Yeah, this is always a time. But of course, if you look at this one, that's the exception. You have this is hits of the term for this is these are facets. This is a histogram facet. This is a hits facet. So each one will be like a you can specify your type. If we go back to the, this panel. So you do this often enough, you can get some RSI, so, but at least, yeah, it's the users that are getting it, right?
Keyboard friendly, yeah.
Not right now. So, yeah, each bar would be or correspond to like your query. So you can kind of construct your query in a way that says you can actually change this query to look like say where the hits are like 1 to 5, right? Or and then 6 to 10. It will be another query. Yeah. And 100 to unfortunately, there's no infinity, so you kind of have to put a arbitrary block, but you kind of know, you have to know, so to get your the graph that you want.
So, but hits is your hack.
Sorry.
Hits is your hack to get whatever x y you want.
In a very limited way, because each x is not actually the x axis is not a continuum, right? It's more like all these are buckets corresponding to your queries. So you play around with your query. Yeah, but I'm sure the graphing can be done for any kind of data. I mean, it can be modified to do that. So, here is the map. Internally, I'm not really using that. I just created this for the demo. And this is what we talk about. This is called a table, right? A table facet. And you can see the table. You want to see the JSON, how it looks like. And see the raw color just goes away. I wonder why they bothered. So and you can kind of say add filter. You can add filters right from here, right, to show this value or to match this value or not to match. Okay, of course this no query register for field. Okay, how do I get this back?
Refresh.
Yeah. Good.
I know you said that you'll store, right? Actually, whatever you change here.
Oh, you have to save. You have to save. Yeah, so you can actually afford to make a few mistakes. Did I just run myself in the corner here? Okay, we are good. Yeah. So, click on country and that's your right the top hits, right? And then the terms facet, the bar, pie chart, table, and in different forms, the same information in different forms. So that's what I'm talking about when you say prioritize. Okay, so Australians are our best customers right now, okay? So let's focus on those. So maybe I can create a. Oh, you can even put plain text panels. Each one of these is a panel. You can put it here to add instructions or documentation, right, for the uninitiated. So when you're adding a panel, you have there are stuff like this is a better map. It works on GPS coordinates. The map works on country codes. Then you have column, histogram. The first two that we saw, right, this left the one on the left is a histogram. This is a hits. Yeah.
Can you add panel types?
Add panel types?
How do you add?
I guess that's in the, you have to change the source code for that. Yeah. So terms, text, even trends, right? So that's okay. So within a histogram, this is just anything. Values. What do you want for the chart value? Okay. Yeah, you can choose it. You can switch it on the fly, or you can just create multiple panels, one for each. The only other shortcoming that I discovered is that you can't actually plot like the average and the 95th percentile on the same histogram. Yeah, which theoretically is possible, logical, but right now it doesn't support multiple values. Yeah. You can plot different queries, but then not a different kind of statistical
side by side.
Yeah, side by side. Yeah, that's a workaround. But still,
you see, you're working on tile 95. So is it you modify something to put that option in, or is it?
Most of the change was in Elasticsearch to do the calculation, right? To store the values and do the calculation. The only change I did in Kibana was to add this string inside the array. So what it would do is this Kibana would coordinate with Elasticsearch, right? I'm asking for this thing, right, by name, and with this Elasticsearch would know what to calculate, right? So these are actually streaming aggregates. Means by default you do not have to store the values that you see, right? But when you want to do quantiles, you have to basically remember everything, right, and do a sorting and do, right. We were quite disappointed that it wasn't available out of the box. But I guess there's a practical reason for that. Right, so time field by default is timestamp. You can change this as long as it's a valid date. Yeah, right. Date string is fine. Time correction, blah blah blah. You can choose resolution. It's a number of data points in your bucket. So multiple series are your stack, percent, cumulative, or individual. I usually turn this off for my needs. You can choose bars, lines, points. And you can even do your queries, right? By default, all queries are graphed. Oh, thanks. But if you find every query too noisy, you can kind of select a few.
I think the extensions are quite good with the values. Is it all documented, or we have to actually figure out how Kibana or Elasticsearch or
Sorry?
How you extend it? Is it documented, like this is how you extend the system?
Is
it? grab
change.
Really?
Yeah. Of course there is developer documentation, but then it takes a while, right? There's just so much. Looking at the source code itself, I still feel overwhelmed, right? So Kibana is easier, but Elasticsearch is like, wow. So what I did was, I've been using this only for like a month plus, right? Mm. So what I did was, okay, you see total, mean, max, okay. Prep for these terms, okay, they are there in a few files.
Find ways to edit.
Yeah, then, hard code some values, see if they show up here, right? That's That's about the easiest that I can can do. So you can, yeah, you can add this zoom in zoom. Oh, why is the zoom missing? That's a good question. So if you design this kind of flexibility, then yes, it's good. So but it's always a balance, because like now because our business is very good. I'm running into storage issues because we have 600 million records for 2 weeks. I don't think a 20 node cluster is enough. So, right, and if you have that huge a bucket, right, when one bucket has 2 million records, you're gonna watch the thing crawl. So, take your pick.
So yeah. This thing can use Hadoop as the data source.
I think that will be part of Elasticsearch.
Elasticsearch.
Yes.
So Elasticsearch pulls data from Hadoop.
Yes. Yeah. I'm still not too familiar with that right now, but they have a they have a Hadoop extension for that.
I looked at it. It seems like it reads the shards out of Hadoop, but I don't know exactly how. I don't know if Kibana can take the analytics off of Hadoop.
Yeah, search your Hadoop data and get real-time results. So this is probably the next step I'm going to, because organization-wide, they actually store all the logs inside Hadoop, but those will be raw logs, right? I have to figure out how to deal with those. But in a way, you can't really grab one full year's worth of data, which is like a few, you know, 100 billion records. You might have to say, okay, select for this month or these from this time to this time, and do a, you know, not an instant query, but do a, you know, deferred query, right, to kind of do some processing. Yeah. But I guess that concludes our session for today. That's all I have. Yeah.
Any more questions for Bob?
Did you look at any other ones? Was it basically just Kibana, since you had all your data invested?
There's a lot of in terms of visualization tools and libraries, there are a lot of solutions, but the special thing about Kibana is the tight integration with Elasticsearch. So out of the box, right? I mean, just this. What I actually did was, right, I cloned the Kibana repo, right? Run my HTTP server, and of course, I have an Elasticsearch running, and yeah, right, and there we go, right? It just works. So it even has a Logstash dashboard, right? With the Logstash index convention, so it looks at some predefined index names that Logstash uses. So if you bring in your data through Logstash, there's actually really very minimum that you have to do, right? So it just works out of the box. Sample dashboard, right? It tells you, okay, this will give you a full view of all your data. You can start to do your dashboards.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, everybody.
So the Hackers and Painters thing.